Yes, welcome back. Now we would like to see indenting business, what are do's and don'ts, right? So don't enter into the market unless your study and market research on the products to be launched is not completed. So you need to complete your market's research and survey and launching of the product in totality and then go and launch the product, right? So don't go haphazard way, or don't go, when the research is not complete, and launch your product for the marketing. Never ever give any credit. Don't give any open credit to bag any order unless backed up by letter of credit or bank guarantee. Means there should be either advance payment or there should be the backup of letter of credit, which is an instrument for payment, and bank guarantee or any other kind of collateral. So don't go give any open credit, because most of the businesses are into the vicious cycle because they are giving the open credit and they are stuck up. They have to continuously supply to the customer, otherwise they will not make the payment. So it is not a good good cycle happening, that unless you don't supply you will not get the payment and kind of situation. So no credit to be offered. Never ever compromise on quality or specifications of a product and payment terms. So the specs desired by the customer, you should not deviate from the specification. And if our supplier is having certain kind of specs, you thoroughly check with the customer whether these are acceptable to them. Many times it cannot match 100% to 100%, but 99.9% and customer is okay. But if it matches 100% in terms of commodity product, or those are the sold in a mass scale, so they are like a commercial product. So that specs is already set, and by it is sold by the grade or the brand name kind of thing. But otherwise, don't compromise onto the specification. Be very transparent with the customer, and from customer end, if you have any specs, be transparent with the supplier, and then let them find that okay, it can be done kind of situation, or certain parameters are okay, 99.9% it is okay, 0.1% okay or not okay, or 1% okay or not okay. So no compromise on specification and also the payment terms. Suppose your supplier is giving X payment terms, say advance payment, then you have to talk to the customer, advance payment that we later see or something like that, and then you go ahead with the deal and then you are not able to comply to the advance payment norm given by the supplier. So no compromise on specs, no compromise on payment term. This is a very most important kind of don'ts into indenting business, or rather this is for any business. Never ever encourage supplier or a buyer with any hidden agenda. Means be very transparent in the sense what supplier is able to offer, what shipment, what time and what category of the product, and same way whether customer requires a kind of product which is available, whether available with the supplier, existing supplier, or we have to search for the new supplier. So we don't have to keep any hidden agenda that we'll go with some sample, then we'll go with one container and we are talking about 10 containers. No, if it is one container, let us talk about one container. If it is a sample, let us talk about a sample. If it is 10 containers, let us talk about our requirement from the customer, 10 containers, because otherwise the supplier will be misguided. Similar way, if the customer want 10 containers, and if it is not available, initially only you hint them that there is a shortage or it has been already sold out. So we may have to get one or two containers, start the business, and then we can take next month some more and more like that. So no hidden agenda. Deal as far as possible on top of the line of the credible suppliers and the customers. So your suppliers and your customers both are to be top of the line. So normally if we have 100 customers shortlisted or to be documented, and out of which you are meeting about 50 customers, and then you are shortlisted 30 customers, and 10 customers, top 10 customers, maybe it is a different application or same application or whatever, so you have a top 10 customers now, and deal with the top of the end of every application or ABC analysis wise, top of the customer line, and same the top of the supplier line. So there is no major quality issues or any payment terms, or the things are very standardized. They have ISO 9000, they have the certain specification requirement, they have proper specification analysis methods, tools, and kind of regime what they are into it as a region, right? So we have to be as far as possible dealing with the top of the line of customers and suppliers like that. Deal with total commitment as an indenter or as a mediator, deal with total commitment and integrity. Why? It is most required. You know, if we don't keep the integrity, then what will happen? If there is a chance to earn more money or something, there is a shortage, we should not do like that. If we are taking a commission of $10, unless the supplier decides to give more or something because you are doing excellent job, otherwise don't in between haphazardly change the terms of the terms of your commission with the supplier, or even don't try to get because it is a shortage product and you are taking a commission from the supplier and now you want from the customer because it is shortage. It has to be a long-term thing, and we have to work with the total commitment to get this cargo in time, specification, payment term, not extracting more money from the supplier or a customer. Rather, customer we normally don't take unless the supplier is a government company, then we need to take it from the customers, our commission or a consulting fees. Decide the deal with the supplier and customers with the transparency, and make them aware of the product, desired order, shipments and specs and packing and price and payment terms and a timely shipment and validity of the offer, detention period when the vessel comes to the particular port. At that port, that container will have how many days detention free time and any other terms which are required by the customer or a supplier, and terms of indenter with the supplier or in case with the buyer, right? So decide in totality and list it down, and by checklist that okay, this is taken care, this is taken care, so that we don't have any ambiguity during the deal or after the deal. There is no dissatisfaction of the customer or even the supplier, right? Make the supplier and the buyers to perform their commitment. Whatever they have to be delivered and which is talked about, let the supplier deliver in time, quality, and all in all respect the documentation in time. And same way, the customer has to make the timely payment and get the product as per the the LC terms. And we have to retire the document, as a customer has to retire the document in time. So support each other. So though it is a matchmaking and we are mediator, it doesn't mean that it is basically the contract between the supplier and the buyer. Main contract for the cargo, and we are just taking the facilitating commission. So they have to believe in this contract and they have to execute. So you have to be pretty clear about from the supplier's contract to the customer and from customer's requirement to the supplier, right? So all mutually agreed upon, and the same way we have to work upon and tell the buyer and supplier that mediator, we are the mediator or the indenter, so they should not bypass us and directly go, so that there may be any misunderstanding which may be difficult for us to resolve. So better follow the channel. So we are like a postman, or we always say, or we are like a matchmaking person, or we are like to bring the both parties together, and we have to handle that ego between the buyer and supplier sometime. I'm not saying in a bad way ego, but there is a strong ego, or they are in a hurry, the customer is in a hurry, or supplier is not having the cargo. So we have to really properly your own indenter thing as a buffer. We are as a buffer. So we will try to reduce the anxiety of the supplier and the buyer. So in total, this is what if we follow, then at least you are not going to have according to me, in hundreds of consignments what I dealt as an indenter. So there was no problem for the buyer to get the specification because we have a world-class reputed supplier. And same way, we have the best kind of customers, top of the line. So our suppliers didn't face any problem in the payment or any kind of getting the document or letter of credit or, you know, any kind of the cooperation for signing the contract or anything. There was not any problem from the customer side to the supplier side. So this can happen when we set the norms. And initially may be difficult, and we'll have to tell the customer that once you take the contract, you have to honor the contract. And same way, it is vice versa also. Once the supplier issues the contract, then there is no revision in the price, especially for the upward price. And the shipment has to be timely or given within the time frame of the, say, during November, means it should be up to 30th November. Or if it is mentioned in 10th, up to 10th December, then it has to be done before that, right? So if you try to follow this do's and don'ts, means rather, other than that don'ts, whatever your business norms normally you follow, you can follow. And this also you can, not to do or don'ts, you can follow in your business or, anywhere you are dealing into any transactions, you can be very careful by this kind of thing, and which may help you, right? So this is my duty to tell you, so that you don't make any loss at all, and so that indirectly you make the profit, or you make your commission, or you make buyer and supplier happy, and they will not only deal in your product what you are supplying, but they will customer will come back to you and ask more and more products. This is what is happening with me, and this is how we are able to diversify into many products, because the customers only will come out and tell you, or somebody else of his customer, then they will say, you go to this is a credible indenter, and there is a good chance for us to do more and more business. Thank you so much for patient listening. I hope if you are having any issues or any problems, but before you can talk to us, right? Thank you so much. Ha, bula.